Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are perfectly fine and doing your studies at your home. Students, I am here with a new online video class in which we will discuss some assignment of chapter number 1. Students, firstly, I will remind you once again that you will fill your book firstly, then you will write all the exercises in your fear copy. So without any delay, let's start our video. So these are the exercise of chapter number 1, which is Oliver finds a home. Students, on the page number 8, you have given an exercise which is exercise number 4. It is tick the correct options. So you have given 3 questions and 4 options. So you have to tick on the correct option. First is Mrs. Marley and Rose Bob. Your options are waiting for the police to arrive, B option having a grand party, C option waiting for the doctor to arrive, option number D discussing an interesting book. So option number C is right option. Second question, Dr. Losburn asked for, options are some medicines, some tea and pie, some warm water and clean sheets, and last option some clean towels. So option number C is right option. Mrs. Marley and Rose, this is the third question. Options are were angry with Oliver, felt sorry for Oliver, option C decided to hand over to the police, option D wanted to send Oliver to an orphanage. So option number B is the right option. Moving to the question number B, which is answer this question, and question number C think and answer. I have sent these questions in the PDF, so you will write all the answer of this question from watching my PDF. Okay, so move to the question number D, which is tick the synonyms of the words in capitals. So you have given 6 questions and you have to tick on the right synonym of the given word. So first one is innocent. So synonym of innocent is blameless. So option number C is right option. Second is intelligent. So synonym of intelligent is clever. So option number A is right option. Third question, strength. Synonym of strength is might. So option number B is right option. Question number 4, pleased. So synonym of pleased is glad. That's why option number C is right option. Risk. Synonym of risk is danger. Option number C is right option. Question number last, rage. Synonym of rage is anger. So you will tick on the C option. Now moving to the question number E, you have given the list of words and circle those that show ways of looking and speaking. In the first column you have given the word of look, and in the second column you have given the word related to speak, and you have to circle the words that shows way of looking and the way of speaking. So first, limp. It is not, the meaning of limp is not look. Bury, glance. So you will circle on glance, then gaze, then glimpse, then view, then watch. Now in the speaking column you will circle announce, scream, murmur, narrate, mumble and utter. Now the next, complete the table below with correct contraction of the words. This is question number F. So words are given and contractions are given. You have given some blanks, so you have to fill those blanks with the contraction of given words. So first, did not. Contraction of did not is didn't. Contraction of does not, so you will write doesn't. Okay. Has not, hasn't. Have not, haven't. Is not, isn't. Now the second, I will, I, it is given. You will, so you write you will. Okay. They will, they. I have, I. So they have, they. Okay. So this is the question number F. Now moving to the next question. It is related to sentence. And firstly we will discuss what is sentence. So a sentence is a group of words that makes a complete sense. A sentence must always have a verb, and there are four types of sentence which is given in your book. First is statement. A sentence that tells us something is a statement. Second is question. A sentence that asks something is a question. Third, imperative. A sentence that gives a command or makes a request is an imperative sentence. Last, exclamatory. A sentence that expresses a sudden or strong feeling is an exclamatory sentence. So now in the question number G, you have to read these sentences and circle the correct options within the brackets. So first is, Oliver went to an old gentleman to read and write. So it is a statement. So you will circle on statement. Where will the 2018 FIFA World Cup be held? It is a question, so you will circle on question. The 2020 Summer Olympics will be held in Tokyo. It is a statement, so you will circle on statement. Don't run down the stairs. It is imperative, so you will circle on imperative. Fifth question, what a brave little girl she is. It is exclamatory sentence, so you will circle on exclamatory sentence. Now moving to the question number H. Complete these sentences in your own words using question marks, full stops or exclamation marks. Write S for statement, Q for question, E for exclamatory or I for imperative in the brackets. So you have given 5 questions and you have given blanks, and you have also given blank in the bracket. So you have to firstly complete the sentence, then you have to write S for the statement, Q for the question, E for the exclamatory and I for imperative. Now let's do this exercise. Question number H. First is, has the dog barked at the strangers? You will put question mark, then you will write Q in the given bracket. Next is, Sarayu wants to meet you. It is, then you will put full stop. It is a statement, so you will write S in the bracket. Do not open the window. You will put full stop. It is imperative sentence, so you will write I in the given bracket. Are you coming with me? Question mark, and you will write Q in the given bracket. How pretty she is. After this, you will put exclamation mark and you will write E in the given bracket. Now, question number I. Match these interjections with what they express. First, bravo. You will match bravo with the appreciation. Second, alas. Alas. You will match alas with the grief. That is the second. Second is matched with D. Oh, it is surprise. So you will match oh with the surprise. Fourth, hurrah. You will match hurrah with joy. So you will match fourth with the E. Fifth, hush. It is silence. So you will match fifth with the B. Now moving to the next page. On the page number 11, you have given communication skills. So question number J is, your teacher will read out the names of some authors and their works. Listen carefully and match the column. So this exercise is given at the end page of your book. You have to match the writers with their works. So it is explained at the last page of your book on the page number 117. First chapter, Oliver finds a home. I am reading this. First is, Oliver Twist is one of the most famous novels by Charles Dickens. It means Oliver Twist is written by Charles Dickens. Second, Swami and Friends by R.K. Narayan tells the story of three friends and their adventures. It means Swami and Friends is written by R.K. Narayan. Lewis Carroll's Alice's Adventures in Wonderland is popular with both children and adults. It means Adventure in Wonderland. Alice's Adventure in Wonderland is written by Lewis Carroll. Fourth is Tom and Huck are famous characters from Mark Twain's The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. So the Adventure of Tom Sawyer is written by Mark Twain. Fifth is The Wonderful Wizard of Oz is a popular American children's novel by Anne Frank Baum. Six is Pride and Prejudice is a classic by Jane Austen. So now moving to the question, you have to match the works with your writers. So first is given Swami and Friends. Swami and Friends is written by R.K. Narayan. So you will match first with the C. Second, Pride and Prejudice is written by Jane Austen. So you will match second with the A. Oliver Twist is written by Charles Dickens, so you will match third with the F. Fourth, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland is written by Lewis Carroll, so you will match fourth with the B. The Adventures of Tom Sawyer is written by Mark Twain, so you will match fifth with the D. And last one is The Wonderful Wizard of Oz. It is written by L. Frank Baum. So that's it for today. You will firstly fill your book, then you will write all the exercise in your fear copy. By PDF you will write the question answer in your CW copy as well as in your fear copy. For today video lecture, that's it. We will meet soon with another video lecture. Till then you will complete your fear copy at your home. Goodbye.